So my name is Hannah McKenna. I'm a research assistant at the Cognitive Neurology and Alzheimer's Disease Center at Northwestern University. And the study that I work on looks at primary progressive aphasia, or PPA. It is a rare form of dementia that affects your language and communication abilities, and so it leads to a gradual loss of being able to communicate with others. So specifically, my study hopes to connect these patients with PPA with speech-language pathologists throughout the country. And we do that through a web-based program like Skype or FaceTime or Google Hangouts. So what we try to do is we connect the people who come into our center with our speech-language pathologist. She knows a lot about PPA. And together they work over 8 weeks in therapy sessions where they work on improving their quality of life or improving their day-to-day activities by learning strategies and exercises that can help them communicate better despite their diagnosis. So I am a Washington native, so my home is the Pacific Northwest. You could say I'm from Seattle, so I'm a Seattleite. My dad is an electrical engineer at Boeing, and my mom used to teach literature in South Korea before my parents both moved. And so I think I got a holistic sense of all the different things growing up. So there was math and science emphasis from my parents, but also a lot of exposure to art and literature and music. And so I think that growing up in that way translated a lot to my different interests. So I really grew up with a strong dream of going into medicine, but it's been very important for me growing up to kind of hit all of these different arenas and to make sure that when I'm doing something, that I'm doing things with a lot of different factors in mind. Even though people regard science as one field, it's actually very interdisciplinary in nature. And a lot of the reason why I kind of latched onto this particular position at this lab is because the research that we do is interdisciplinary in nature. So our center's motto is from cells to social work. So it's not just about sitting in a wet lab and pipetting liquids. It's about face-to-face interaction with people, about figuring out how the biomedical science that we work on at one end will affect how we treat patients in the clinic or in hospitals. And so I love being able to get up in the morning to meet people over the course of 2 years, however long they choose to come into our center, and figuring out ways to take what we learn in science, take what we figure out through research, and turn it into something that people can use to improve their lives, you know, even if it is marred by a neurodegenerative disease. Everybody is unique and everyone is special, so why should there be one treatment, one form of medication for everyone? Everything should be a little bit different depending on the individual person. I know that when my mom was first diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, it was very difficult trying to get the care that fit our lifestyle and our household. So my mom is from South Korea, and a lot of times the meals that we plan are 50% Korean cuisine and 50% Western cuisine. And I remember sitting through diabetes education classes with my mom, and everything that we were taught about how to regulate your food and your nutrition was based on a Western culture or a Western idea of eating and dining and health. And that was very frustrating to me because it wasn't taking into account the person behind all of the science. And so a lot of the reason why I want to go into medicine or why I'm interested in the science is figuring out how we take something that is so vast and so complex and figure out how to tailor that to each individual in a way that improves their life or gives them the foundation to live the kind of life that they want. I think that my parents have always put a great deal of emphasis on my education. What ended up being, I think, the overarching effect is really loving learning. Finding out on your own that it is exciting when you pick up on a new fact or a new concept that you didn't know before. And maybe you don't realize it at the time when people are outside playing basketball and you're not one of them, but after a while that kind of is something that is instilled in you, the love of learning. And that has really kind of powered me through a really difficult undergraduate career, additional science classes on top of that, and hopefully through 4 years of medical school and beyond.